Thank you, Acting Deputy President. I want to speak tonight about the inaugural function that was organised by the Parliamentary Friends of Caravanning yesterday. There were three caravans out the front of Parliament House in Federation Mall, which actually demonstrated the innovation of caravanning and manufacturing in this country. I want to acknowledge my co-convener, Scott Buchholz, the federal member for Wright. And I also want to outline to the Senate chamber tonight how critically important and what role that caravanning and motorhoming has to our economic benefit here in this country. It's not just about touring and having a good time, although all that socialising is very important, but there's such a strong economic basis to this sector in this country. It also develops our tourism and it supports our tourism industry right around this country. It's so important in terms of regional and rural jobs. It's creating opportunities to keep families in regional Australia. We live, no doubt, in the best country in the world. And one of the reasons it is the best country in the world is because of our wilderness, our national highways, our road networks, and the great open spaces here in Australia. And what adventure, what this wilderness does, it excites Australians and international visitors, of course, to go and explore the great masses of Australia. The weekend is synonymous with getting out in that wilderness with your family and friends and going on a fun adventure to see the beauty of our great southern land. This friendship group aims to share how caravanning and motorhomes helps to build the great Australian road trip adventure. Over countless years and eras, Australia's expansive roads and regional wonders have enlightened and excited Australians to explore our beautiful country, from Lockhart River in Queensland down to Port Arthur in my home state of Tasmania. It is part of who we are as a nation. We are explorers, we're adventurers, we're innovators. While caravanning has brought immense joy to a great many Australian nomads and our families, this is not the only value that is uniquely Australian experience has brought to our country. Caravanning and motorhome industry is also one of the biggest supporters of regional jobs, tourism operators, manufacturing and small businesses throughout this nation. There are over 6,000 businesses across the entire caravan and camping supply chain. Most of us are not aware of the significant economic impact the caravan industry makes to our economy, with an impressive annual contribution of $23.8 billion to our national economy. This sector employs directly in excess of 50,000 Australians. I want to also acknowledge the Caravan Industry Association, its peak body, for what they do in raising awareness about this very important sector. And I would also like to put on record and thank the CEO, Stuart Lamont, and also Luke Chippendale for working with us to establish this friendship group and to bring together this wonderful event last night. It was great to have the board of the Caravanning Association, but I'd like to particularly also acknowledge Andrew Hewitt from Auscorp, who is an innovator in this industry. He operates out of Victoria, and we saw a fully electronic van that runs off solar power entirely. And what this innovation is doing is help prepare for the EV change that is happening in this country and how caravanning is an important part of that innovation. I'd also like a special shout out to Dennis Austin, the president of Caravanning in my home state of Tasmania. It was fantastic fantastic to have all of those in Parliament House, many of them for the first time in Parliament House, and being able to show them around and give them a good impression of the amount of interest there is, not only from this chamber but the other place, in supporting this really important sector. What it brings, as I said, to rural and regional Australia cannot be underestimated, the value of that. And I am so proud to be the co-convener with Scott. So more from us as we go forward.
Your time has expired. Senator McLaughlin.
Thank you. I want honourable senators to try and imagine a coastline of breathtaking beauty. I'm fortunate enough that I don't have to imagine such a place. I know of such a place. It goes by the name Port Nalunga. It saddens me to inform the chamber that a section of this beautiful and unique part of South Australian coastline could have been put at risk if not for a community uprising. A parcel of untouched sand dunes, which is owned by the South Australian government, is being considered for sale. The land, described by the bureaucrats as Lot 108, is zoned for residential housing. It sits alongside a magnificent conservation reserve, which, like 108 itself, contains pristine sand dunes that have miraculously survived the aggressive urbanisation that has marked our recent histories. The dunes are an oasis of biodiversity, a redoubt pushing back on the relentless attacks from our modern way of living, a way of living that fails to properly value nature in all its magnificence, but instead takes the easy path and worships the false gods of consumption. Yet the dunes hold out against all odds. The Port Nalunga community all rightly want their precious sand dunes to remain untouched. The wider mid-coast want their natural inheritance, their beautiful environment, to be valued as a community asset, for it to be passed on to the next generation. Lot 108 must be protected and kept safe from being ravaged by the developers' bulldozers. I ask, how can a price be put on Lot 108? It has immeasurable value. It has stood silently as the world around it has been scarred. I ask again, why must the priceless be priced? In recent weeks, a community-led petition was launched to prevent the sale of this land. The petition has attracted incredible support. There is also an electronic petition, which I hope to table in this place. I'm very pleased to declare to the Senate that the coastal community of the South has secured a great victory. I have this week received strong assurances from the State Minister for Planning that the lot will not be sold for the purposes of development. I thank the Minister for listening to the loud and passionate voices of the mid-coast. But we must not rest until the land has been rezoned or other necessary legal protections are put in place that make it impossible for this beautiful oasis to ever be touched by development. I ask all those in South Australia who value their natural inheritance to join this fight and maintain their vigilance over all the sacred places that have been handed down to us.
Senator Grogan.
The Albanese Labor government has a deep and abiding commitment to achieving gender equity, which is why we've announced important initiatives over the past weeks that aim to address the persistent and systemic issues that women continue to face. I'm very proud